guys, welcome to this new video. My name is Eric Patterson. Today we are going to talk about version control. So today we'll start the series of Git for beginners. So what is a version control? So that's a question that someone that does not know Git or any version control tool, we ask the question, what is a version control? So I will take you through and demonstrate to you and explain to you in a simple layman language, what is a version control? Now, imagine that you have a piece of code like this. So this is a piece of code of Docker Compose made of two services. So imagine you have a piece of code like this made of two services. And later on, you make some few changes. As you can see here, you change the service, the first service from web to front end. And you also change the second service image tag from MySQL latest to MySQL 5.7. And also you change the MySQL root password, which was example underscore password, to this. Now, that's called version control, right? That called version control here, but imagine you made that change. So we went from this to this here. Now, in the Git world, we are going to have something like this. Something that shows us the change that we have made. As you can see, everything that is red is what was removed, and everything that is green is what was actually added. As you can see here, we went from version 3.8 to 3. We went from web to front end. We went from MySQL latest to MySQL 5.7, and we went from this password here to that password there. So that is what is called version control, meaning that you are able to trace the change, you are able to trace the history that you made on a particular piece of code. That's very important to know what was removed, what was added. Having that history is very important. So it helped the developer actually debug. Let's say, for example, a code was working and you later on add something and that code is not working no more. You are going to need a version control which show you exactly what was added or what was removed, and that will help you debug that piece of code. So that is how developers, they are able to produce powerful software. They are able to produce software that help us in our day-to-day life, because when they are writing the piece of code that allow that software to allow that software to work, they can see the history. They can go ahead and correct any mistake and correct any issue that happened by the magic of version control. And also one important thing, for example, one advantage that of version control is that multiple people, right? Many people can work on the same piece of code. Like many people, we want the same piece of code, like I mentioned earlier, and we are able to trace, right? We are able to trace the history of the project. So the history of the project can be tracked. And all the magic happened because of Git. So actually, all this happened because of Git. With Git, Git will help us manage, do the version control. With Git, we help us trace the history of change in our code. Now, there are two types of version control. Now, imagine that you have a code repository. So you have a repository. So like I explained on my GitHub videos, a repository is just a bucket where we put all the codes. Like code are made of folder and file. You can have folder file. You can have, you know, all type of, can have folder file, audio, video. You put that in something called a bucket. That bucket is called repository. So imagine that you have a repository. And we are going to talk about here the first type of version control, which is a centralized version control system. Now, you are going to have few users, the user John, Henry, James, and Paul. And all those users are going to connect to the repository. Now, if the repository dies, so this is centralized version control system. So imagine that you have those four users. They each connect to the same repository and they start working on that repository. There's a problem. If there is something happen and the repository die, what's going to happen is that they won't be able to work no more. and they will lose history of what they were doing because they were all working under the same repository. Then we have to wait until the repository is back to operations, meaning that as of now, John, Henry, Paul, and James will be just sitting there doing nothing because they have nowhere to do this, the version control system. The only bucket, which is a repository, the only repository that they were working on actually is down. This is not recommended. People used to do this back in the day. It is not done no more. Now we have something called the centralized, the distributed version control system, which is much better than the centralized version control system. So on a distributed version control system, you are going to have four users. And the advantage of this is that all the four users are going to have the code, everyone on the locally, meaning that all of them are going to have the piece of code on their laptop, on their virtual machine, or anywhere that they have Git installed. So John is going to have his own piece of code. Henry is going to have the own piece of code. James is going to have his own piece of code. Paul is going to have his own piece of code. Now, these are the same code. They are just having the same copy. So the code that John, Henry, and James, Paul have is actually the same code. It is just a copy. And they made a copy of that code from the repository, right? They made a copy of that code from the repository. So every one of them will individually work on the code, then they will use Git to push the code into the central bucket, right? They will use Git to push the code into the central bucket. Now, the advantage of this is that if, for example, the bucket die, if, for example, the repository die, John, Henry, James, and Paul can keep continue working because they still have the copy of the code in their local repository. When I say local repository, imagine this as they still have the piece of code on their laptop or on the virtual machine that they are working. So it doesn't matter if the repository go down, they can keep working compared to the centralized system that when the repository goes down, because if every single user does not have a copy of the code, then we have to wait until the repository is back. So in this case, the repository is down, John continued to work, Henry continued to work, James continued to work, Paul continued to work, and at the end of the day, when the repository is back, they will just commit their code back to the repository. As you guys can see, it's a big advantage because when the repository was actually malfunctioning, the four users were still able to work. And this is possible because of Git, right? This is possible also because of Git. Like we say, Git is a very powerful tool. It's a very powerful tool that allows version control system. So version control system, just to summarize, it's just a system that allows us to actually trace history in our code. And it is very important when you're writing a piece of code, you want to know the change that you made over time. That will help you debug the code if you have any issue. I hope you like the video. If you like, go ahead. Don't forget to subscribe. And also don't forget to follow us on social media such as platform, TikTok, Instagram, LinkedIn, and many more. See you in the next video. Thank you.